Hello friends, and welcome back to Swift Lessons for another By Request song tutorial. In today's session, I'm going to be breaking down Neil Young's 1972 classic, Needle and the Damage Done. So in this tutorial, we're going to break down the instrumental section, which is played intermittently throughout the song between the verses. Then we're going to simplify those techniques to perform the verse sections. You can follow along using my tablature and also my complete chord sheet at patreon.com/swiftlessons. Support the channel there and gain access to a ton of extra resources for all my popular YouTube guitar lessons. Now, let's get started with a full demonstration of the tune. I want to invite you to see what you can figure out using your ear and your musical intuition. Then you can jump into the instructional segments.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Knocking at my cellar door. I love you, baby. Can I have some more? All the damage done. I hit the city and I lost my band. I watched the needle take another man. Gone. I sing the song because I love the man. I know that some of you don't understand. Milk blood to keep from running out. I seen the needle and the damage done. A little part of it in everyone. In every junkie's like a setting sun. I seen the needle and the damage done. A little part of it in everyone. And every junkie's like a setting sun.
Okay, a close look at the fretboard, getting started with our intro slash instrumental section. We're in standard tuning, the key of D major. So I'm going to show you this in a stripped down kind of fashion. We're going to target just the lead tones that we're hearing throughout this cross picking pattern. But I want you to keep in mind that when Neil plays it, he adds a lot more strums into his technique, usually just 3 strings at a time to add a little bit of robustness. But we're going to start off with the target notes, then we'll add those strums in to thicken things up. Okay, it's going to sound like this at a slow tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4, and... Okay, let's break that down. Okay, getting started with measure number 1 sounds like this. Okay, with the count, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I've got a D major chord set up. All right, we're gonna grab the open D string, followed by an upstroke on the G string. All right, then we're gonna strum through the G string to the high E string. Nice and robust. All right, then an upstroke. The high E string is the target note, but we want to try to get a little bit of the B string in there as well. All right, from there, it's just going to be back and forth between the D string and the B string. Okay, but as I mentioned before, Neil likes to thicken things up, so you can play grabbing a little bit of the G string on the downstrokes and also on the upstrokes. Okay, put all that together and we've got. Okay, now moving on to the next measure, it's going to sound like this. Okay, so I just took my middle finger, brought it up to the C note on the third fret of the A string. This makes the chord D sus 2 slash C. All right, we're grabbing the A string, followed by the B string, then onto the G string. One and two. All right, then onto the high E string open. All right, that's half of measure two there. All right, then finally back to the root notes, third fret A string, back to the B, to the G string, and then to the high E string. All right, one thing I remember about this particular measure is that he doesn't strike the D string at all. Okay, put all that together and we've got. All right, you thicken that up with some adjacent strings and we have. Just like that. Okay, now putting measures one and two together real slow. Let's see if you can count along. One, two, three, four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and. Okay, now moving on to the next chord, we're gonna have G6 slash B. Just leave the ring finger down and grab the A string second fret. Here we're gonna perform. Okay, so that was the A string to the B string, open D string, and then to the high E string with the B string. Okay, that's half a measure. All right, then on beat number three, we're back to the root note, to the B string, open D, and then to the B string again. Okay, put that together and we've got one and two and three and four. One thing I notice here is that he keeps going back to the bass tone on beat number three. Okay, so it's really important that you make those kinds of mnemonic devices when you're trying to learn a piece. Okay, so you put that together and we've got one more time. Put it together with the other two measures. Okay, now we're going to apply the exact same pattern that we had for G6 slash B to G minor 6 slash B. Just flatten the bass to the first fret of the A string. Okay, remember to experiment with adding in some adjacent strings just to thicken things up. Okay, now at this point you're going to be transitioning to a C chord. So it's okay to play an open B string. In fact, I hear it in the original track. Right there at the end, as you transition to a C major chord and get yourself started with line number two, following along with that tablature. Okay, now demonstrating all of line number two. One, two, three, four, and... Okay, so that began with the C major chord shape. Grab the bass note. Alright, then an upstroke on the B string and G string together. That's followed by a hammer-on. Open D string to the second fret. Then to the high E string open. Put that together and we've got. Alright, next, we're gonna strum the G string and B string together. And then grab the high E string again. So far you've got. I then finish up with another hammer. I strummed the G string and B string together, and I'm hammering on the G string 0 to 2, and then going to the high E string open. Okay, you got a full measure of C major now. It's a little bit of a shuffle feel. Okay, next we're going on to the chord F major. Technically an F major 7, since we have the high E string. This measure sounds like this. Okay, again with that shuffle feel. Okay, so we had the pinky down on the third fret of the G string. So now I've got 3-3-1-0. Technically an F major 7 sus 4 chord. Very melodic. Okay, we're gonna downstroke on the D, G, and B, followed by an upstroke on the high E string and B string. Okay, now remove the pinky. Alright, now remove the middle finger. And then we're gonna put the middle finger back, and then follow up with another upstroke. Now you might just wanna hit open strings at the end as you prepare to slide into an E sus 4 chord. Okay, this chord shape we're stacking. The second fret of the A string, second fret D, second fret G. Alright, one of my favorite chords. Very good for moving down to an E major chord shape. Okay, which is what Neil is going to do. Okay, so here we're sliding on the G string, one up to two, and then following up with the high E string and the B string open. Okay, so we have. All right, now grab the D string and follow up with another upstroke. Then the A string, and then the low E string. All right, put that together and we've got. Now we're gonna do mostly the same thing with an E major chord shape, but this time with a hammer. So hammering 0 to 1 on the G string. And if you want to, you can hammer down the entire E major chord shape. And then follow up with the upstroke. Then to the D string, upstroke, A string, upstroke. All right, then the open A string, followed by an upstroke on the open strings. That'll get you to a D major chord shape to start your first verse. Okay, playing all of line two together, we've got. I caught you knocking at my cellar door. Okay, if you can do that, you're ready to move into the verse section. Okay, great work everybody. Now let's take everything we just learned and put it all together. Two lines of music starting with the D major chord shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. Let's get started with the verse section. Okay, very good everybody. We have the intro slash instrumental section down. Now we're jumping into the verse where things are going to get much more simple. It's going to sound like this at a slow tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1.
I caught you knocking at my cellar door. I love you, baby. Can I have some more?
Okay, so that began with the D major chord shape. Alright, we're playing 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and striking the bass note. Alright, then strumming eighth notes on the G string, B string, and high E string. Do the same thing on the D sus 2 slash C. On the G 6 slash B. And on the G minor 6 slash B. Alright, next we're going to go to a C major chord, but we're going to add in the high G note, 3rd fret of the high E string. Bass, down, up, down, up, down, up. Alright, the same thing for the F major chord shape. Just take the ring finger and middle finger to the D string and G string. Bass, down, up, down. Keeping that high G. Okay, so far you have.
I caught you're knocking at my cellar door. I love you, baby, can I have some more?
The C major chord.
Oh, oh, the damage.
All right, then finish up with the E sus 4 to the E chord, where we're going to throw in a quick little riff. Okay, so I have the E sus 4 chord stacking those fingers, bass, down, up, down, up, down, up, and then this very cool riff. Okay, so I grab the E major chord shape. All right, this measure is going to begin with the low E string, open, followed by an upstroke. All right, then hammer the A string, 0 to 2, followed by another upstroke. So for you have 1 and 2 and All right, then we're going to slide 2 to 4 on the D string, and then hit another upstroke. Go back to the second fret, D string. All right, then another upstroke to finish the measure, and from there we're just gonna start over. Okay, now if you listen to the unplugged version, you'll notice that he does a little walk up in place of that last riff. So you could play 1, 2, and 3, 4, grabbing the second fret of the G string, then the open B string. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and... Just like that. Okay, so you put that entire verse together now, and we have a review. 1, 2, 3, D. To the C. G6. Minor 6. Okay, or to get back to the D major chord and start the next verse. Okay, so there you have it, everybody. You got that intro section. Got the verse.
I seen the needle and the damage done. A little part of it in everyone.
Play with the strumming pattern a little bit.
And every junk is like a setting sun.
And the riff. Congratulations, everybody. You're ready to perform. All right, friends, thanks so much for checking out this Neil Young guitar tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. As always, big thanks to my supporters at patreon.com/swiftlessons. Hope you're enjoying all those extra resources. And thanks to you guys, I got many more lessons coming up, so keep checking in. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy pickin'.